Hello, my name is Cormac Garvey. I work as a HPC architect in the Azure Global HPC team. Today, I'd like to spend a few minutes walking you through one of the ways to do a deployment of a HPC end-to-end environment in Azure. So what does a typical HPC environment consist of? Well, first, it consists of a network, which defines the address space we're working in. It also has some storage component. And in the case of HPC, typically that's a high-performance parallel file system which can handle the large I/O requirements. It also has a head node which allows you to log into the HPC cluster and schedule jobs to some type of job scheduler. Also, in the cloud, ideally, you would like to have some auto-scaling capability that computation resources, compute and GPU would scale up and scale down depending on the load on the queue. In today's deployment, we would like to use two tools to do this deployment. The first is Azure HPC, which is an open source flexible deployment, HPC deployment framework. The second tool that we're going to utilize is CycleCloud, which is an Azure HPC product, and it's ideal for lift and shift scenarios in which there is some sort of HPC scheduler component. Also, CycleCloud has advanced auto-scaling and cost management capabilities. So what are we deploying today? First of all, we're deploying a VNet, and the VNet will describe the address space. The address space will be carved up into different subnets. We're also going to deploy a jump box, and the jump box is where the Azure HPC install scripts will deploy or deploy from or run from. Also, the jump box will act as an NFS server. For the parallel file system, we're going to deploy BGFS. We're also going to deploy a CycleCloud server and leverage its excellent PBS integration and its auto-scaling capability. Also note that in the case of the Cycle server, all of its computational resources will be deployed into the compute subnet. So when using Azure HPC, there are a couple of prerequisites. The first is you need to use a reasonably new version of the Azure CLI. Also, you'll need to have Git and JQ installed because we need those tools to clone the repository, and JQ is used to parse JSON files. Now, you can do the deployment from a Linux workstation, or if you prefer, you can use the Azure Cloud Shell. Now, in the case if you use the Azure Cloud Shell, the prerequisites which I mentioned are already automatically installed for you. And also, when you're doing any sort of deployment, it's also important to make sure you have sufficient quota. If you don't have sufficient quota, you can easily request a quota increase. So the first step is, depending on whatever where you're working from, whether it's a Linux workstation or the Azure Cloud Shell, is to git clone the Azure HPC repository. Once the repository is cloned, the next step is to source the Azure HPC install.sh script. This will set up the Azure HPC environment for you. All that's required now at this stage is to create a JSON config file which will describe the HPC deployment we want to do. In today's deployment, we're going to work through one of the Azure HPC examples. So in the examples, there is a directory called cc_bgfs. It's always best practice when using Azure HPC to not deploy within the repository. So it's important to create a working directory outside the repository. So first step, we'll create a working directory outside the repository. We'll copy two files from the cc_bgfs directory to a working directory. That is the init.sh script and the variables.json file. All that's required now is to go and edit some of the global variables that are defined in the variables.json file. So we need to set appropriate values for the resource group, location, UUID, and what scheduler we want to use. In this case, we're going to use PBS. So once that's done, all that's required now is to actually execute the init.sh in our current working directory. This will effectively loop over all of the building blocks, the HPC building blocks we want to use in our deployment. It will reference the global variables that were set in the variables.json file. So once we execute the init.sh, it will create a number of files in our current working directory. The two files that we're primarily interested in for the next steps are the two configuration files generated, prerequisites.json and config.json. In this particular example, there is an additional prerequisite. We do need to have created an Azure Key Vault, and the SQL Server administrative password needs to be contained in the Key Vault. This is best practice in Azure. So fortunately, the prerequisites.json file does this for us. So we use the Azure HPC build command, passing in the dash dash no VNet option, because at this stage, we're not creating a VNet. We're just creating the Key Vault. And then we specify the configuration file we want to use with the dash C option, in this case, prerequisites.json. So once the prerequisites are all set up, all we need to do at this stage is to run the Azure HPC build command. Now, when you run the Azure HPC build command, it expects to see a config.json file in the current working directory, which we have. So the Azure HPC build will read the config file, the config.json file that we created. It will create an ARM template. The Azure Resource Manager will then read that template and deploy the resources in parallel. Once all the resources have been deployed, the Azure HPC install scripts will execute on the virtual machine and virtual machine scale sets with the appropriate tagging. When this is completed, our deployment is done. All that is required, all that's needed at this stage is you bring up a web browser, go to the SQL Server URL, give it the administrative user and password to log in. At this stage, you should see the CycleCloud cluster that we created. In this case, it was named PBS Cycle. All that we need to do at this stage is actually start the CycleCloud cluster. So we hit the start button, which effectively starts the CycleCloud master. Once the master is up and running, we're now ready to go ahead and log into the CycleCloud master and submit jobs to the PBS job scheduler. The CycleCloud auto-scaling capability will then spin up the appropriate computational resources to run the jobs on the job queue. When there are no more jobs in the job queue, CycleCloud will automatically delete computational resources or scale down the resources to reduce cost. Now, also note that the CycleCloud auto-scaling capability can be customized to whatever core requirements that you have. When you're finished working with the HPC environment that you just deployed, there is a convenience command to delete all of the resources that you deployed. So just execute the azhpc destroy in your current working directory. That will go ahead and delete all of the resources in your resource group. Now, today we walk through a specific deployment of a HPC end-to-end environment in Azure. In Azure HPC, under the examples directory, there are many building blocks to choose from. We can combine those building blocks to create more complex HPC deployments very easily. Also note that in the Azure HPC apps directory, there are over 30 commercial and open source installation and run scripts that you can choose from. I really appreciate you spending some time with me today. I hope this session was useful on your journey in Azure. Thank you so much for your time.